Okay, so now that we have our block cut and trimmed, we have our lines on the top face and an edge. The next step is to use a file to put what's called a chamfer along all of the 8 long edges. So we're only doing the 8 long edges. Most of our files are half round. One side is curved, one side is flat. We need to use the flat side for this part. I've taken my block, clamped it long ways in a vise. Okay. This is going to help us for a few reasons. If we had you clamp it the other way, what happens all the time is people start filing the vise instead of filing their wood. Hopefully, for obvious reasons, we don't want that to happen. So, clamp this in here well enough it's not going to move around on me. What a chamfer is we're going to make this a 45, we're going to take our 90 degree angle here, our square edge, and turn it into a 45 degree angle. For this, we don't really need to mark this. You could, and it's not that bad of an idea if you do. On here, we have that we want to have an 1/8 of an inch chamfer, 1/8 by 45 chamfer. So basically what that means is I want to come down 1/8 of an inch this way, and back 1/8 of an inch this way until I hit both of those lines. Okay, so to do this, flat side, two hands on the file. You can stand or sit, it's up to you. I like to sit, it's more comfortable for me. And this only cuts on the forward stroke. This is not sandpaper, do not go back and forth, just the forward stroke. You will need to put some pressure into it. You shouldn't need to lean into it, but it takes pressure. And as you're working, you can do one of a few things. You can either go straight, a little bit at a time and keep moving, or I like to go forward and across at the same time. Okay. Do not do this. I see this all the time in class. This does literally nothing. You'll be here forever, and you're not going to get anything accomplished. It must go forward as you slide. And forward stroke is key. One thing I'd like to point out, while you're filing, you may find that it doesn't seem like it's actually doing anything. If you're filing correctly and you're going forward, you know, using the forward stroke and applying good pressure, and this is clamped in well and not moving on you, sometimes it gets clogged up with all the sawdust. In the tool cabinet, right beside the files, we have a bunch of these little wire brushes. These are called file cards. They are used to clean all that stuff out of the files. So, if need be, grab one, clean it out. Be careful not to rub it across yourself, it'll hurt, and then just put them back. But sometimes that is necessary. So, I have now hit my two marks. It looks a little uneven here because there's a bit of a warp to the board. That's all right. It's pretty much the same. My chamfer is pretty much the same width the whole way across here. That's what I want to have happen. Now that I have that done, take this out and turn it 90 degrees. These edges are rounded. We're still going to chamfer them anyway. We don't want it rounded. We want it chamfered, which again is a flat 45 degree angle. Technically, whatever angle you want it to be, but ours is going to be 45. Tap it in. Really what I want to do, I could mark again, or I can just try and make it the same as this edge here. So I'll start over here, work across. When you're going across the grain, and the grain is the lines running the wood, it tends to be a lot easier than going against it, like when we did the end here. So this side should be much easier and faster. It's already done. So at this point, I'm going to go ahead and continue. I did these two edges, I'm going to do these two edges, I'm going to flip it to the other face, the opposite face, I'm going to do all four long edges here. Okay. I am not doing the short sides, do not do these, just four long ones here, four long ones here, and so you can see a little better, I gotta see what I'm looking at here, but that is what a chamfer should look like. Let's make all four long edges on top and all four long edges on the bottom look roughly like that.